Today is Pentecost, right? We got up our beautiful red banners. Thank you, Miss Betty. And I've got on my red sneakers, if you didn't see them. It's the birthday of the church, right? So what does that mean? Do we get presents? Well, we've got balloons, so... We've got balloons, so... what does it mean that this is the first day of the church? It's the day that they were celebrating Pentecost, right? And we talk about Pentecost in our understanding as Christians. Pentecost is the day that the Holy Spirit came upon the church. And here's the other thing for you to contemplate that we're not really going to get into this morning, but Jesus' ascension was 10 days ago. Okay, Jesus ascended into heaven 40 days after Easter. We're now 50 days after Easter. So in the early church, there was a 10-day period when the disciples were alone. Jesus wasn't with them. And according to our reading here today, the Spirit wasn't with them either. God told us, Jesus told us at the end of Matthew, that He was going to be with us always, even to the end of the age. But there's a 10-day period there where maybe the Spirit wasn't there. Is that true? Did the Spirit only come on the day of Pentecost? I have one person over here answering. No. We can actually read into Genesis, and as Christians, we read into Genesis. This is not the way that the Jewish interpretation of Genesis is, though, but we can read into Genesis that God spoke. And who is the Word of God? Jesus. And His breath moved over the waters. And breath and spirit in both Hebrew and Greek are the same word. So in God, in Genesis, when He spoke, His Spirit moved over the waters. So here we have God the Father speaking with God the Son, Spirit, breath moving over the waters, Spirit. All three of them present at the creation. So the Spirit wasn't necessarily absent. Maybe they just didn't know that He was there. But we look at the Spirit as, our reading this morning calls Him or her advocate. Right? Advocate. We've talked about the Holy Spirit before as advocate. We've talked about the Holy Spirit as helper. We've talked about the Holy Spirit as comforter. Right? This morning in our reading in Acts, how does the Holy Spirit come to us? Anybody remember? Wasn't fire. What kind of wind? A violent, rushing wind. How many of you have ever been in a tornado or a hurricane? Is it comforting? Because that's a violent, rushing wind. To me, that's not very comforting. How does that help us? Does the Spirit always comfort? And when the Spirit advocates, who does the Spirit advocate for? Us? Or somebody else? Do you want to come up here and finish for me?
For those of you who didn't hear, she said, Jesus. And the answer to the confirmation class, you know, normally Jesus isn't the answer, but this morning Jesus was the answer. So the Spirit doesn't advocate for us. And I have to tell you, I have to be honest this morning, I've been struggling since Thursday evening with this. Who the Spirit is and how the Spirit moves in and about our lives and how we act in the world. And we call upon the Spirit. We say, come, Holy Spirit. We ask the Spirit to come into our lives and to be with us as advocate and comforter for us. When that's not really who the Spirit is. The choir sang this morning, come, Holy Spirit, and fill me with your power, right? Or something close to that. And do we really know what we're saying when we ask that? Is advocate or comforter a good name for the Holy Spirit? And I don't think it is. And a couple of people that I've talked to doesn't think it is either. The word actually that we need to focus on here is paraclete. And my wife is smiling because she knows where the joke is going. And if some of you saw what I carried in here earlier, you might know where I'm going with this too. We talked about paraclete, right? Not a paraclete.
Thank you.
Or a parakeet, a small yellow bird. But paraclete is the Greek word here that John uses and is used five times in the whole of the New Testament. The word that we have here is advocate. It's used four times in the Gospel of John and one time in the first letter of John. Paraclete. It means advocate. It means comforter. It means helper. In our language, coming from a language that we can't always put into the words of our English language, the word paraclete means advocate or comforter or helper, and that's not good. The thing that we need to understand about the Spirit is someone who, in the real meaning of the word paraclete, comes alongside. The Holy Spirit is a companion for you in your journey. How many of you have ever had a companion in your life that has brought you comfort in a time when you've needed someone to be there for you? How many of you have ever had a companion in your life kick you in the butt and put you into gear when you needed to get off your bottom and do something? I think all of us, if we're honest, could say yes to both of those. And that's exactly what the Spirit is. The Spirit is someone who's going to come alongside you, and in Romans, this morning it talks about how the Spirit is one who lifts your prayer concerns to God with sighs too deep for words. In those moments in time when you don't know what to say, and you don't know what to feel, and you don't know what's going on, the Spirit is there to be a comfort to you, to lift your prayer concerns to God in sounds that we can't even comprehend. And the Spirit is also there in those moments when we get too complacent with the way things have been to kick us in the butt and get us out of the pews and send us out into the world to do what God has called us to do. Because He didn't ask us to build buildings and maintain them and keep communities going for His name. He told us to go into the world and make disciples of all people, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and teaching them everything that I've taught you. He didn't tell us to stay complacent within the walls of the confines of our churches. He told us to go out and to share that great news with everybody. Because the Spirit didn't come to fix our problems. The Spirit came to tell us to do what Jesus told us to do. Which is to go and tell everybody. So when we pray, come Holy Spirit, fill my heart and come alongside with me. Are we sure we really want that? Because sometimes the Spirit is going to tell us that everything's going to be okay. And at other times the Spirit is going to grab us by the arm and pull us out into the world and tell us to do what Jesus told us to do. But that's what the Spirit is there for. He's not our advocate. He's Jesus' advocate. And He's there to help us to know that we have the power to go and do God's will. So I ask Jesus to give you the paraclete, not a paraclete, but the paraclete, the one who will be with you always, to walk alongside you, and to help you do what He's empowered and gifted you to do in all of the world.